see how his hand on my head is not so welcoming, but more like how he withdrew his energy so he could attack me with the other side. He didn't know he was going to do that. In his intellect, he's sure he's welcoming me. But these other parts of his brain are keeping him in defense because they relate to the perception of threat that I am. I've kept him not in aikido mode, but in defense mode. Okay, so let's change it. So, who are you? You can't come in here. Take off your mask. Oh, Richard. Comes in. It's ruined, right? Okay. You can't come in here. Take off your mask. Richard, how are you? You feel welcomed?
No.
I got a spirit. Okay, one more time. Don't come in. If you're welcome, there's a withdrawal there. Okay. One more time. You can't come in here. You're scared of the children. Richard, you silly guy. Come on, Anderson. Okay, so this is not so easy, you may have found out, because we have these unconscious things that we don't often recognize. They're happening involuntarily. So we're going to move on to the next thing and maybe come back to this if we have some time. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the way beneficent intention creates an aikido that we may not know is there. I stopped teaching from technique a long time ago and I started teaching from intention because I found that people who have never even seen aikido techniques with this kind of operation will suddenly be doing all the techniques we know without ever having been shown a single one of them. Okay? So here's what I want you to do. I'm going to say, hey, Richard, I'm so thirsty. Now, John Sensei in the morning was talking about how difficult it is sometimes for us to understand the nature of attack in this aikido relationship because we're on the mat, we're practicing, and we don't have really an attack intention. And yet, aikido kind of requires this intention to form the flow that's going to make the aikido happen naturally. So it's really difficult, I know, for me to maintain an attack intention without a real reason, because an attack intention is serious business. And our brains even respond to an attack intention with a little bit of its own shielding, because in our inner senses that we know when we attack, we make ourselves vulnerable. So instead of attacking, I'm going to do something to his limbic system that's going to have the same effect as an attack. It's going to feel as authentic as an attack energy. It's going to be an attack, it's going to be an energy flow that comes from a desperate need. So I'm going to put pressure on the center by demanding or really insisting on a glass of water, please. Can I have some water? I'm so thirsty.
I don't have any.
Okay, no. Yeah, ask him about his hand. We want this intention to come not from behind the door. I said no. Right up on the floor.
How do we
use
chocolate?
Well, here, what should happen? spontaneously manifesting aikido comes from? All right, give it a try. Like, want water, and you got to really want to get your head in.